September 16th today, very special day in my life. It is the day that my mama was born. Matilda Nancy Rafa Cuomo. Look at her there. She looks even better today. I love you, mama. Happy birthday. Enjoy being 51. Thank you for watching. CNN Tonight with its big star, Dee Lemon, starts right now.
Mrs. Cuomo.
She doesn't like you.
Happy birthday. It doesn't matter.
She
I love
loves
her.
You. She loves you, Don Lemon. You know why? Because you're pretty.
Oh, please. Because she's a smart lady. Talking about pretty, I don't know, you know.
Oh, thanks.
You did not get her looks or your dad.
Sorry. I thought you were talking about me.
No, I'm talking about your mom.
Oh,
look at
she does
that.
Look
I mean,
good.
She is gorgeous.
I was at her house today. She was talking the talk. She's
How's
telling
she doing?
Me how I got to look. I got to wear different suits. She doesn't like my hair. She's all kinds of
she
stuff.
She doesn't like the same outfit every night?
She doesn't like anything. She's okay. All about improvement, but she loves me. I'm her baby.
You got to listen to mom. Mom doesn't, you know, when I cut my hair in the summer, and my mom's like, put some hair on your head. You don't look good that way. Stay out of the sun.
They really know how to hurt you.
Yeah, I know, right? But what a wonderful lady. Mrs. Cuomo, sincerely, happy birthday. Now let's talk about, I had the pastor on last night. Let's talk about this. To people like my mom, who vote every time, to the church going, I always talk about the women in the church hats, what the pastor said is very frustrating for them. Because what they will say to you is, did Dr. King not vote because things weren't changing fast enough, because the candidates weren't perfect? And they will say, no, he voted, and that's how we got to where we are now. They think there's one choice in this election, especially this one, and you know what that choice is. And if, you know, you talked about how black women are carrying the party, always, you know, help.
Statistically.
I think that I always say, and I've learned this from political strategists, know when to be strategic, know when to be an activist, and there are certain times where you have to be one, not the other, and there are certain times when you can be both together. You know this because you come from a political family. No candidate is perfect. Not one. There's one candidate, there's one group of people running, two people who are running, where there's a person of color on the ticket, okay? So there's only one person who has a color on the ticket, a person of color on the ticket with him, and that is Joe Biden. And the candidate takes you, it's like getting on a bus. It's like public transportation. The person who takes you the closest to your stop, to where you want to be, that is the closest to what you want to get done, because no one is going to get everything done. That is the person you vote for. It's not like an Uber that drops you off right at the location, shows up when you want. It is a public transportation. You don't have to fall in love with the person. Republicans know this better than anyone. They fall in line.
Oh, yeah.
Because they know this is the person that's going to carry out what I want, most likely to carry out what I want. And I think Democrats want to fall in love, they want a perfect candidate, and on and on and on, and then they end up, that's what happened. Hillary Clinton, 2016, Jill Stein, then now everyone, you don't complain if you vote for a third party person and you don't get what you want.
Because you say Jill Stein, she was the Green Party candidate, the pastor Carl Day voted for Jill Stein in 2016. Just one question and I'll leave you alone on it.
Yes, sir.
I agree. I have been told this by you and many people in the black community frequently, okay? The position of Day and others, as you know, you field it all the time, is right, but we're frustrated too. And I'm not going to vote for Trump, which is what the pastor said. No way. But, you know, what am I getting other than this terrible guy not getting him, right? This is their perspective. At least tell me that you're going to try to do something for me. Because otherwise, my frustration gets the better of me.
Yeah.
Response?
Listen, that's all fair. And as I told him last night, you can vote for who you want to vote for. If you want to vote for a third party, for whatever, fourth party, fifth party, that's your business. That's your prerogative. I'm just analyzing. I'm just giving you analysis at this point. What people have to realize, and no matter what side you're on, no matter who you're going to vote for, the Supreme Court for the next 50 years is going to be decided in this election. So do you believe in a woman's right to choose or not? Do you believe in same-sex marriage? Because that may be an issue with that. What do you believe? What are you willing to compromise to vote for a third party or to stay at home?
And I think because the third party won't win.
Because the third party never wins. And again, I'm not telling you who to vote for or whatever, but the third party never, ever wins. I personally think that this is, everyone says, oh, it's hard. I can't see how anybody's undecided right now. This is the easiest.
There is a very low number, by the way.
But I think people who are undecided are just making excuses because they want to support someone, but they just don't want to say it. That's just my personal opinion.
Mm. So you think undecided break right?
I think undecided tend to break right. There are people who are afraid right now or don't want to say at this moment that they want to support President Trump. But here's what I will say. I think this is the easiest election to decide. I just think because the four people who are running are so completely different that if you cannot make up your mind between Joe Biden and Donald Trump or Kamala Harris and Mike Pence, I think it's the easiest election ever.
Well, you want to hear the good news?
Yeah.
On the morning of November 4th, you know who will probably be together?
You know what?
Watching the results.
You know what? What'd you say?
On the morning of November 4th, the day after the election, you know who will probably be together watching the results trickle in?
Oh, my
And
gosh.
All of the counting that is still yet to be had and how close the race actually is.
The night owls.
And the discussion
CNN
about
dark, early
people
morning.
Who voted in person versus the signatures that they're going through.
Yeah.
Captain Handsome here and you.
Yeah.
That's who it's going to be.
All right, Captain. Love you.
I love you, Don Lemon. Thank you for the analysis. It helps me understand things that I don't understand as easily.
This is the easiest election ever, really. This is decision-wise. Thank you, sir. Love you. Talk to you soon. This is CNN Tonight. I am Don Lemon, and we do have some breaking news.